Seriously, like low key, before we did this, like I don't think I actually recorded with you for the episodes that you did.
Never.
On Adventure
once.
Time. So like when they were like, oh, he's on your panel, I was like,
who is
did,
he?
Yeah. Did he work on Adventure Time?
Who is that guy? I'm the guy that I make sure the mics are on at the recording studio Cartoon Network.
No, you're not.
I sneak in. Are you already ready to ask a question?
I think this guy is.
Wow, he's really on it.
This guy's trying to take pictures.
He knows the game. Oh, by the way, for those of you who don't know, it's pretty much we're just winging it, really. But it's just a like Q&A panel, so if you want to ask us weird questions and such, just line up in an orderly fashion right
follow,
down yonder.
Yeah, right behind Ming the Merciless.
And we will probably get to you, maybe not. Yeah, so you can run like this guy and elbow people to get a better spot in line, too. Feel free.
I think we all like to ramble, so let's try to keep the answers.
Just for the record, no question anyone could ever ask about Adventure Time demands you running that fast around this crowd right now. No. In a respectful, nurturing, caring way, I mean that.
All right, to Dana. How the hell did you get into this?
Number one. Language, first off.
This is a family
That's right.
show.
That's right. You got Deadpool back there. He's very upset. He's very sensitive ears. How did I get into the show?
Well,
I have
panel.
Incriminating photos of... No. voiceover?
What is that noise?
Panel. This panel in particular.
How did I get into this panel?
He kind of bribed his way on, to be honest.
I have incriminating photos of the promoter. I make him put me on every panel. I'm on every panel. I'm in the Star Trek panel. I got a William Shatner thing I got to do in about 2 hours. William Shatner, cast of Star Trek, William Shatner and Dana Snyder. Like, hey, remember me? I'm the crew guy. I got eaten by the Gorn captain in episode 6. I'm like a Highlander. I never age. I've been doing television for 60 years.
Thank you very much.
Good question. He waited to ask that, by the way. That was
Jeremy?
Yeah.
I don't know if you remember my friend from Friday. She had red hair and she gave you like a stuffed dog.
Yes, I do actually. I still have it. It's a little it's a little miniature schnauzer. It's super
she
cute.
She asked me to ask you. When are you going to ask her out?
Like outside? Like out of the building? Or?
No, I don't know if she's here or not. But
yeah. I'm not down with the lingo that the kids are using these days. So I don't know, man. I don't know.
All right, thank you.
Tell her it's going to take a lot more than a taxidermy dog.
Hi. So what was it like to have Marceline become such a big breakout star and work on the kind of miniseries? And is there another miniseries in the works?
Ooh. You know, they didn't even tell me. Like, I remember the exchange when Kent was like, okay, so next week we're starting Stakes. I was like, we're gonna go on like a steak dinner, like I don't
grill, barbecue.
And he was like, "No, like your spinoff miniseries, whatever." And I was like, "Huh?" And he was like, "No one told you this? Like, yeah, we're doing an 8-episode thing, whatever. Like, you don't know this?" And I was like, "Now I do, I guess." I was really excited about it, but after like the first episode, they let me think for like 2 weeks that I was gonna be killed off. Like, after episode 1 and 2, I was like, no, you guys are killing me off. They're like, we're sorry. I know we should have given you a heads up. Find a new job. But it's really cool. And I don't know if we can say, but we are going to be doing more miniseries.
Yeah.
But
all I can say.
Other characters.
I'll handle. Yeah, Dana can
I'm prepared to tell you this.
Yeah. Well, what do we got going up next?
First off, there's been an announcement. Where'd he go? Jose, can you see? Okay. They need everybody to scoot over. Or fill into the seats down here instead of standing up. Is that right?
The fire has
or
just
not.
Point at people.
Or don't.
Or get out.
Yeah.
Just take like a big
that's all.
Sit.
Make a
one
friend.
Or two seats.
If you're not touching elbows, you're sitting wrong in these chairs. They've been systematically designed to be as close
as possible.
You
guys are like the only ones we could see in the front row. Is like, nope.
Yeah, well,
not
you know, the front row, you can just pop in there.
They're pretty much all the way over.
Deadpool,
so
there's a seat right here, right down here.
Oh, perfect. Thank you. Thank you, Super,
yeah,
Super Boy.
We don't need any wise guys right now. Okay, this is a fire marshal. There's lots on the line here.
To answer your question, though, Yes, there will be more miniseries. We have a couple more coming up. I can't say more than that. It'll be, yeah, they'll focus on a few other characters. There might even be some of them that actually, this is shocking, some of them might actually involve Finn a little bit more. Wow. Yeah. It's crazy.
And it's also, crazy. Without giving like plot away or anything, but the miniseries, all, there's like little Easter eggs in each one that connect to the next one. So keep your eyes open.
Guys, what we're talking about is they find the plans for the Death Star, okay?
AKA, go rewatch Stakes so you can know what to find when the next one comes out.
I will. Thank you.
There's a lot of crossover with the Marvel Universe in the next season. Spoiler alert.
This question is mainly for Olivia.
I kind of guessed it considering your shirt. It might just be happenstance, but.
Which song that Marceline has sung would be your favorite? Because I know it's been a lot now.
Yeah. So. I think the most recent one that just came out, Francis Forever from Battle of the Bands, that was really fun because, you know, this whole series they've talked about Marceline being this like rocker chick, but all of her songs were really like slow and kind of just emo and sad. Like,
just
you never
emotional.
Really saw. Yeah, like, and so this was kind of the first one where you see her with like a full band and like singing a song that's actually like a rock song. So that was really fun, and I kind of got to wail a little bit on that one. Are you guys hearing that too?
Yeah.
Okay.
I have a pacemaker. It's picking up everything. I have two pacemakers for my secondary one for my first one in case that one goes out. It's the runner, the jogger. You did a 1K in here to ask this question. I'm assuming it's going to be the greatest question that has ever been asked about Adventure Time of the literally hundreds of thousands of questions that people have asked about Adventure Time.
Yes.
So what is it?
No pressure. I wanted to ask, out of everything in Adventure Time, what is your by far favorite scene of all time?
Damn good question. I'm just gonna give it to you right there. It's pretty good.
I try.
That's so hard. I guess I'm just gonna go with like one of my favorite episodes, and I don't know why. It's probably the lamest scene in all Adventure Time, but it's from Box Prince, just where Jeremy's or Finn is rolling around with all the cats and boxes and. I don't know. I really like the super random episodes. I also was talking with someone at my table. I love the scene in, it's like Time Sandwich or Jake the Dog or one Finn the Human, one of those episodes where he's in Prismo's cube and he's like, you can have any wish in the world. You're not going to save your best friend from sure death. And you want a sandwich? Like, I'll just make you a sandwich, dude. Like, come on. Do a little better than that. That's like one of my favorite lines.
I have quite a few favorites. Hard to narrow it down. But one of my faves is... It has nothing to do with Finn. The frick is happening. It has nothing to do with Finn, actually. It's a Jake moment. But there's an episode where Tree Trunks and the pig are like... macking on each other like the whole time and everyone's getting super grossed out about it. And so at the end of the episode, they have to like separate them physically. Don't you freaking do it. No.
Is it mine?
I can't tell.
He said don't keep these covered like this. Just keep it open. Yeah. Okay. Pretend you're riding a bicycle. Or we're rolling.
So basically... They get separated,
yeah.
And at the end of the episode, Jake is separating the pig, and he's taking him home, and he's like, sorry about all that, man, so where do you live? And the pig just goes, I'm homeless. And Jake's like, ooh. I love that moment. It's super funny.
P.S. when you did the two hands, then you looked like a motivational speaker. I'm going to tell you how to turn $10 into $100 million in real estate.
Ow.
It feels so unnatural.
No, you had your question. I'm sorry. You don't get that answer. Mine, obviously, the scene where the train comes out. And I had that one line in that one episode called The Train.
It's a good
That's
line.
Right. But it was the classic line. I'm the train. That was the line.
All right. Thank you, guys.
Now run back to your seat as fast as possible. Oh, tired out, huh? Those 20 feet really tired you out. You should take a lap, actually. Take a whole lap around here. Okay.
Oh, wow.
Don't be a maniac. Don't hurt anybody. But seriously, take the lap. No, go down to the front.
Hey, how you doing?
Hi, how are you?
I kind of came here at random. I don't really know where I'm at. Okay, I know it's adventure time, but...
Where am I, man?
No, for a second I was confused.
And you're wearing all khaki. If you stood against that back wall, you'd just be look like a floating head right now.
I mean, do you like it, though? Is it pretty good?
No, like the back wall, it's the same color as your clothes. You just see your head floating.
Yeah, I mean, my tan skin would kind
of... Good illusion.
Okay, yeah. Would you guys want to be in the Adventure Time world? Like, if it was a real-life thing, would you want to be inside of it? Like, you be Finn, you be Marceline.
Oh, like be ourselves in the actual like show world.
I'd be very rarely in it. So I think even you love Adventure Time?
I mean, kind of
it's
like...
It's all right. I just wanted air conditioning and a seat. I just came in here. All these people have great questions. You're like, eh, I'm just passing
time. I
didn't
really know what to say.
If anybody was really in Adventure Time, I think everybody would just freak the hell out. You'd be like, what's going on?
I think Jeremy would have a lot of pressure to be like, Finn has a lot of responsibility.
Yeah, and Finn's more adventurous and knows how to actually fight dragons and stuff. I think if I actually was in the world of Ooh and I had to fight a dragon, I'd probably die. So I think for my health, being in the world would not be good. But on the other hand, I would turn into a cannibal because there's lots of candy people. So it still wouldn't be good.
So you'd be a dead cannibal.
Yeah.
I mean, if this just said dragon, then like everyone would just be peeing their pants because there's dragons flying around. It's not necessarily.
I mean, I would be into it. I'm immortal, so no one could kill me. I could float.
Could be an eternity of just getting chewed up by a dragon. It's horrible.
Finn is like the most
in its stomach bile.
Finn is like the most killable character when you really think about it in the Land of Ooh. So it's not good.
Aren't you like a queen though? So like, yeah. You get that
queen of
well.
What? I think I know, she's like, the queen because there's no other vampires. She just dubbed herself. She's like, well, since I'm the only one, I guess that makes me queen.
No like, challengers.
Yeah, exactly.
Giving us all nightmares, by the way, now.
What?
You get to sit up there. Go blend in with the wall back there. I want to see if this actually works. In a nurturing, caring way. But a couple seconds. Maybe later. Sit up. You know what? I guarantee you can sit up there at my William Shatner panel. Myself and William Shatner are talking about it.
Do it in the William Shatner panel. Don't even ask. Just go sit up on stage and just see what happens.
It'll go well, I promise.
But make sure someone records it because I want to see
what
that.
What could go wrong?
Hi, this is for Jeremy. I don't know if you remember.
I do.
Remember what?
Wait a minute. You're
that
not the
sounded
one who
really
gave
bad.
A taxidermy dog.
Remember what?
She's in a Rey cosplay. Rey's like my favorite Star Wars character.
But like, I don't know if you remember. Remember what? You or
I,
just?
I had asked you if you could sing the.
Yep, song. I got it. Watch this. For those of you who don't know, this will be a musical rendition of Buff Baby.
I'm gonna film this.
I gotta get into this.
Wait.
Can I go now?
Everyone get your cameras out.
Oh, well, there you go. Wow. I should take a picture of this whole room.
I'm a tough tootin' baby. I can dance like a man. I can shake him off, Benny. I can shake him my can. I'm a tough tootin' baby. I can punch in your buns. Punch in your buns. I can punch all your buns. If you're an evil witch, I will punch you for fun.
Thank you.
Hello.
My
original question was going to be for both of you, but they kind of already asked Marceline. So it was, which one would be your like favorite song of all the songs you guys done?
Probably the one I just sang. I actually hated that song at first, but because I've been asked to sing it so many times, it's actually my favorite now. It's really good.
Jeremy was really embarrassed singing that in the booth. And like the first probably 10 times we did them at like Comic-Con or something like that. Yeah. And he was like, man, I wish that song didn't exist. But now you're like, You got it on.
I got it now. Yeah.
Time to pull out the magic.
Yeah. I'm like, this gets watch going. This.
And I have a question for Jeremy. For between Incredible Crew and Adventure Time, which one is your favorite to do?
Oh, I hate those questions.
P.S. We're not here. He's not at the Incredible Crew panel right now. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, this is an Adventure Time panel. So if I say the other, then that's kind of blaspheming everyone in this room. But I honestly, my actual answer, though, is to be honest, like, I can't really answer that question because they're still two extremely different things. Not only is one a live-action sketch comedy show, but the other one is an animated show. And, I mean, the comedy styles are different. The whole show is different. One actually has an overall storyline. One's just small sketches and stuff. And
that's like
camera.
Out of all your friends, who do you like the most?
Oh, she has one friend she likes the most, I guarantee you. Yeah. She's like, Sandy's all right, but the rest of them, I can't. That's like saying if you had two children, which one you like the most, but they're really different, so one's just like all like has 18 feet, and the other one's just like a really big face you have to carry around.
Exactly.
They're both very different, but you love them both because they're your kids.
Someone asked me that question, and it was technically an Adventure Time panel, but my who plays my dad on Phineas and Ferb sat in on it, and he was like, which one is? And I was just like, who do I pick off? You guys or the guy who gave me my voice acting career?
And they canceled Phineas and Ferb. So if you want the show to be canceled, keep asking questions like that, okay? This show could be hanging on by a thread if you make people answer questions like that.
My question is for Dana. Why do you think...
Hold on, quiet down. I got a question there, guys. Yes, about
the
train.
Why do you think the character you voice, the life-giving magi, his mittens don't come to life when he
his
puts them in?
His mittens don't come...
Yeah, because like, when he accidentally touches things, they come
to life.
Are you
wearing skinny jeans? Let me ask you a question.
No, they're actually...
I don't mean it like... You wearing skinny jeans?
Yeah.
All right. Let's check it. I'm trying to figure out what these are. My friend's telling me about skinny jeans. Well, why aren't the mittens?
Yeah, why don't they come to life?
Because it's an animated cartoon. And it's all of animation is the illusion of life.
Right.
It's not actually alive. And they're lined with Florgan, which will be in next season. You're going to hear a lot about that material. Big, it's one of those 8-piece spinoffs. That's why they don't go on.
Flargon time.
Yeah. Please leave. In a nice way, though. Nurturing currently.
That's not the answer he wanted, you can tell. He's very disappointed.
What is the answer you wanted? Oh, okay.
Okay, there you go.
Security.
Okay, so Ray beat me to my question. That's what I was going to ask. But I want to know, are there any characters in the show that you guys ship, like, personally? Because I have always liked the idea of Marceline and Jake, and now you're both here.
Marceline and Jake?
Or Marceline and Finn.
Wow, dude! Wow! You didn't even know who I play!
I mean, I was just saying no for another reason, obvious reason. Like,
I mix their names up all the time when I'm watching the show, too.
But Marceline and Finn, no.
Thanks.
I mean, okay. In the scheme of things, Marceline is like 1,020 by now.
It's kind of
12, 13.
It's almost as creepy as that relationship from that weird vampire wannabe movie called Twilight.
Yeah.
It's kind of like the Bella Edward thing. He's like 100 years older. Like, that's really, really creepy when you think about it. So that's kind of the same.
And, like, your lifespan is just a tiny blip on Marceline's. Yeah. Like, she's going to be around for forever.
She's had 4,000 boyfriends. Yeah, and she's seen die
she's
of old age.
She's been around. but... Okay, you guys.
Like, don't twist her words.
Is that canon?
What?
Don't you get on the act now, too. I'll get the...
But on a serious note, though...
No.
No. Yeah, no.
But do we ship anybody?
Yeah, I like Finn and Flame Princess quite a bit, actually. I'm down with that camp. I was kind of bummed when they broke up. But personally, I'm kind of in the camp that Finn just needs to be in a relationship. So whether it be Flame Princess or PB or or Marcy, or whoever else, you know. Finn's just surrounded by a lot of awesome ladies, so.
And I love Jake and Raina Korn.
Oh, they're
but,
super
I mean,
cute.
They are for real, so. Is it still considered a ship if they are together in the show? Yeah? Okay. I just think I saw the cutest cosplay of this young couple had triplets, and what, the mom was Raina Korn, the dad was Jake, and they dressed them up like the little pups. It was so cute.
Yeah.
Good afternoon. I have two questions. The first one is, which aspect of the Adventure Time world as the story has gone on really like blindsided you that you had no idea was coming? Like, for example, the Lich.
Like, what, did I have the ability to see into the future?
No. Like, or... just in general, like, you had no idea the show would do that.
All of it.
Yeah, that's all kind of Adventure Time. Have you watched the show?
Yeah, I've seen. I've seen less of it than others here, but I've seen it. And I know quite a bit about.
No,
it.
Yeah, I know. I get what your question is. It's no. I mean, so much of the stuff, like you, especially most shows, generally, especially animated shows, don't go more than like 3 seasons, even. And so the fact that we were able to go on as long as we have gone, and we're still going. It's given us so many opportunities to do so many different things that we would never have gotten the opportunity to do. And so in that aspect, I mean, 90% of the stuff I never would have expected us being able to get to do. So
yeah.
And
they never like tell us ahead of time, like where our characters are going to be going in what direction. As far as like, you know, getting the script and going in that day to record it, I think, I was really shocked in the episode where, like, Betty came back. You know, I thought she was going to be gone. I mean, she's long gone, and all of a sudden, you know, you find out she was, like, just trapped in another dimension somewhere weird. So I'm hoping that, you know, maybe her and Ice King, if he can remember who she is, can pair Poor back guy. Up.
Ship.
Yep. I ship Betty and Ice King for sure.
And second question is, ever since Force Awakens came out, how many Jake the Dog and Finn the Traitor jokes have you heard?
Wait, ever since what came
ever
out?
Ever since Star Wars Force Awakens came out, how many jokes about Jake the Dog and Finn the Traitor have you heard?
Lots.
Oh, I haven't even, like, heard that. Is that new?
Yeah.
Did you see the new Star Wars?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Okay, good.
There's a
movie. Oh! That was almost a thing.
Finn, FN, whatever.
2187.
No, Finn, okay. The traitor.
Finn.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Sorry.
I'm
guys.
Sure them naming him Finn was completely coincidental,
oh, yeah,
too.
Absolutely.
It has just nothing like, to do with the fact that Finn's such a big pop culture thing. But.
I've been keeping track. I've heard it 312 times.
Yeah. Now 313.
I've seriously never have heard that, though.
I've heard it a lot of times, but not in the context of Adventure Time, actually.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
It's a small thing about it. Just wondering if you ever heard it.
Huh? Yeah, it's a funny meme.
How was it to record musical?
How hard is it to record music stuff?
No, the musical episode.
Oh, the episode. Sorry, I get that confused because every time someone says the name, I think they are saying actually like musical, like the word. Oh, the musical.
I think that was the point of the way they worded that.
Yeah. I got that. It was actually part of it was there was one line or two lines in particular that was really, really hard to record because I could not stop laughing, and I don't usually remember specific lines, but this was one of those cases. There was, what is the line? It's like, I'll listen with my heart hole. There's a line where Finn's talking about like, if you open your chest hole, I'll listen with my heart hole. And I don't know why, but on the day I could not get through that line. It took a solid 15 minutes for that one line. So
it was. We all know why.
Yeah.
We all know why.
Yeah, we all know why.
It's ridiculous.
The word hole.
Yeah.
Just, you know. So that line took a while. But otherwise, not. So otherwise, that's good. Yeah.
Also, could you sing Running Errands with My Mom?
I'm running errands with my mom. Running. I'm running errands with my mom. Running. How's that?
Okay, so I actually didn't know Jeremy was on Incredible Crew for a minute, and I just saw that video pop up and was like, did Jeremy seriously make this rap and like think this would be okay to like put out on the internet as his like debut rap single?
Hardcore. Oh yeah. Yeah, I got a lot of people that asked me specifically about that. They're like, so you rap too? It's very interesting. I'm like, that was a joke. But okay.
I'm going to start putting out rap videos as well, but they're the opposite of haul videos. I take things and wrap them up in wrapping paper and take them back to stores. I return things.
Return them and tell them what you hate about the product.
Yes, I complain about how horrible the product is. This did nothing for my face, this cream.
Proactive.
Just look for it, I'm just saying, just for fun.
Can't fix what ain't
broke.
What? Can't fix
what ain't broke. That's right. $1 million face. There's no improvement on this. You've tried the rest, now try the best.
Hi, little dude. How are you?
Good. Who are your favorite characters?
Like, probably besides our own characters.
What's your favorite character?
All of them.
All including all the train, them. Right? Perfect answer.
besides Finn, my favorite character is probably Lumpy Space Princess. Equally with the Ice King. They're both on par for me. Those are my two favorites. I love the two of them. They're so awesome.
I feel like mine always changes. It teeters between Jake, LSP, BMO, Prismo is also... That was like my favorite like obscure character. That and Bounce House Princess.
Who wouldn't love Bounce House Princess?
Oh, she's just like, she opens up her flaps. She's like, wanna come in?
Come bounce on me.
Like I said, who wouldn't love Bounce House Princess?
She's very friendly.
She's accommodating. There he is.
So my question to all of you guys would be, what one princess would you want to date the most?
What would we want to date the most?
Yeah.
Breakfast princess. Aw, yeah.
It's the most important meal
of the day. Yeah.
It's the most important princess meal of the day.
I want to date? Is that what you asked?
Yeah.
Yeah, on the show, like characters that your character would want to date on the show or in real life?
Like you yourself.
Yeah, for breakfast princess, for sure. 100%.
Can I say no one because I'm not attracted to cartoons?
Yes.
Okay. You can. That's, yeah. Sorry.
Me? I'll take your answer too. I'm not going to like make out with a TV screen tonight. Take a TV screen to dinner here and my date's seating right here. Just a freeze frame of Bounce House Princess on the screen. I'll have the spaghetti and meatballs. My charming accompanying me will. Have a steak?
Also, Olivia, could you sing the Busted song?
Oh, goodness. This is an Adventure Time panel. Yeah. I don't sing the whole thing, though. I don't know her part, but I'll sing what I know.
Ashley Tisdale part?
Yeah. Because it's hard, because it's like calling.
Back and forth.
Yeah.
This is an Adventure Time panel. I'm just going to cut this one off.
No, come on. We got. I have to do it for Simon.
No. All right. If you can do it, can you do Ashley Tisdale's part?
Probably not. I can see the things you're doing, and you think that I'm naive. But when I get the goods on you, she'll finally believe. She said it's all just drama, but every bubble's got to pop. She's gonna see just what you're doing, and then you're gonna finally have to stop. Don't think I'm gonna win this time, but you better believe I'm gonna drop a dime on you. I'll get you, yeah, I'll get you. But when I do, you're gonna be busted, busted. Yeah.
Thank you.
That was awesome, not gonna lie. That was super dope.
Lovely.
Hey guys, Adventure Time is one of my favorite shows, and my boyfriend has never seen it, and I can't put it into words, like how to explain it, so I was wondering if you guys could explain it, because he's here right now.
I can tell you how to put it in words, him. You're breaking up with him. Because you don't
unless
know
he watches
my
it.
Favorite thing in the world. Eclipsing you is this show, and now you don't like it, which means you don't like me because you really don't know me, Jerry. And that's why I don't talk when we have dinner together.
I'm going to put it into words of my dad wrote a book for the show, the Adventure Time Encyclopedia, and we filmed this like weird little book trailer for it, and it's a bunch of these little kids dressed up as villagers and wizards and things like that, and he's reading the Enchiridion, explaining the show to his villagers, and he says, it's a show about a boy and his dog and the ice guy and a scary vampire lady and magic. And that's literally how he explains the show. And I think that's pretty accurate.
A boy, no, his dog, a scary witch lady, an ice dude, and there's magic.
Yeah. Oh, and a candy guy.
Yeah. Where's your boyfriend?
He's over there.
Tell him to stand up, please.
Zach.
Where is he? All right. Oh, Captain America. Oh, I'm sorry. You like cool stuff, like a guy who throws a frisbee around all the time, who wears tights and throws frisbee around. Yeah, how dare she like something whimsical and fun. Do you like fun? You like freedom? You like colors? You like dogs? Then what are you waiting for? Download that on your iTunes. By the time we leave, you better watch 3 episodes already and love them, or it's over. She's not taking you to Checkers tonight.
Okay, okay, okay. But in all seriousness, what's his name?
Zach.
In all seriousness, Zach. It's a post-apocalyptic world where, you know, the elements have changed. Instead of what we live with on Earth, it's fire, ice, slime, and candy. You know, Finn here is the only human.
Hi, how are ya?
On the planet. And everyone's just magical as fun, you know? Like,
magical as what?
Magical as fun.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Is it? Yeah.
And they go on adventures all the time.
Or they don't. Sometimes they just sit in and drink soup and play cards. Sometimes.
I think this is very therapeutic for your relationship. I think we've all learned a lot, and we're all pulling for you crazy kids. I think it's going to work out.
My question is, out of all the stupid monsters in the Adventure Time universe, which one is your favorite?
Why'd you look at me when you said stupid?
The monsters. I really like when Finn puts on the Nightosphere amulet and becomes like the ruler of the Nightosphere, but his hat is still as small, so it just gets stretched out and he looks crazy.
That is pretty good, yeah. I don't really know.
Who did you last slay?
I don't know, actually. I don't remember, to be honest.
A slay so
okay,
much.
Okay, you'll have to forgive me. We've done over 200 episodes now, so there's a lot of those.
Do you have a favorite monster?
In the thing.
Probably the farm.
That's mine. That one's mine. That was my favorite one, too. That thing.
I really thought you were going to say farm. The train, but whatever. Good question.
Sorry. Hello, my name is Alexander. It's an honor to meet Finn the Human, Marceline the Vampire, and Shake the Train.
Whatever I play, it's fine.
Yes. I was wondering if you guys would be interested in checking out my sci-fi anime-style book. I brought a free sample.
Free sample, like half a page or something?
It's 2 chapters.
You cut it up into, does it have toothpicks? Like the lady at China Panda Express? It's a sample of my book. It's just 2 words.
I think there's a lot of people who want to get questions done, but if you wanted to bring it by our booth later, we'd love to look at it.
Yeah, for sure. Of course, man. Totally.
Do it. I got one for Jeremy and Olivia.
Yeah.
Okay.
To those people? Oh, if there's any more seats, scooch your pooch to the centers. There's more people who want to come in. Here, make.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Supercon 26, how are you guys doing today? All right, to make the most of the space, I need everybody, if you have a seat, scooch over a room one way or the other, make space so we can make seats for the people who are standing and sitting on the floor. We need the fire lanes open because of our fire marshal code. And
we have an empty seat right over here. Seat for one.
Yeah. All right. So everybody butts to the seat, pretty please. If not, you cannot be standing. We prefer that you be sitting anyway.
Unless you're waiting to ask questions.
Yes. There's a bunch of seats over there, Jose.
There's actually a lot on the side. If you're looking for a seat, there's a ton on the side, too.
Are there empty seats? There's some empty seats back there, guys.
Yeah, if you're sitting by an empty seat, put your hand up. Then they can find it. For the three people.
Lots of over there.
Back in the far left corner.
Cool.
Right, the floor is yours.
Superman.
We have a few seats over here, too, kind of towards the middle.
Superman, what's your question, dude? Go for it.
Yeah, Jeremy, I think you got your job as Finn back when you were 13, if I'm correct, right?
12, but very close, yeah.
12. So how did you get the job? And was Finn's, like, change of his voice, like, over seasons just puberty or an adjustment you made?
Yes. Yes, their puberty is something that happens to every young man at one point or another.
Hopefully.
Hopefully, yeah. If that doesn't happen, you might want to go see a doctor or something. So there was like a flyer, and it was like, we need a young, energetic, annoying sounding voice for this random show. You down? And I was like, sure. That's how I got the job. No, I'm totally kidding. I'm totally screwing with you. Basically, so my older brother Zach actually did the voice of Finn or Penn in the original short, when it was a little short for Nickelodeon. And then they didn't pick it up, and 3 years later, Cartoon Network picked it up to make it an actual series. And they opened up casting. I think they probably just had assumed that the original's voice had changed or something like that. And I auditioned, and my voice sounded just like his did, because I was the same age that he was when he initially auditioned. And then after going back a couple times, I got the job, and nobody knew it was his younger brother until the first day of recording, except maybe Penn. But they just thought they got extremely lucky.
Zach hates his life now.
Yeah. Yeah. No. And I've been doing it ever since. And yeah, during the whole first season, my voice started changing because I was 12 years old about the time when that happened. And all the voice cracks. Yeah, all the voice cracks that happened were not intentional in the beginning. That was just voice cracks. And so after about season 2 or 3, my voice stopped changing, and it's more of a character voice now. Obviously, this is not Finn's voice. Finn's voice is more up here. And yeah, that's kind of how that worked. But luckily, they've aged the character throughout the show, and so I'm in it for the long haul.
So he'll be talking like this pretty soon.
So eventually, Finn will be like, "Yo, Jack, let's go on some adventures, man. Let's have us a good time."
Yeah, but what was the decision to age Finn because of your voice change, or did they just plan that?
So say that again. Sorry.
What was the question? Yeah, was Finn's aging like the director's plan all along, or did they do that?
I don't know if it was their plan from the very beginning, but they just kind of went with it, and they've aged like all the characters throughout the show, so they ended up going with it. I think they had to because
as the seasons went on, you know, they were making it in a way that things were happening, and there was an obvious timeline to it, so it would be kind of silly not to have like a birthday or something for him.
Yeah, exactly. So they just kind of rolled with it, and luckily that gives me job security, which is a very nice thing. That's very good. Yeah.
Okay, cool. And Olivia, have you
actually, honestly, I don't want to be that guy, but we only have 10 minutes, so I want to try and get through as many questions as we can from different people. So if it's okay, I don't want to be that guy, but I want to give people the chance to actually ask a question. One. Yeah, just one. If we could do just one each from here on out, that would be great.
So. Thank you.
We love you.
Thank you. No, those are great questions, though, man. Thank you very much.
Hey, have you ever gotten emotional doing any of the voice acting for any episode?
I did, as the train. I started out very happy. Then by the end of it, I was sad because he died. And they were like, "Hey, he's not in any more episodes." Or is he? Spoiler alert. Who knows? I don't know either, but
I wouldn't say I got emotional doing any of the scenes while we were recording because, you know, we're all there and it's kind of like, It's sort of this environment where you're being stared at by six people through the glass, and then you have your castmates next to you, and you know, it's more fun when we're all together.
It's pretty lighthearted environment, yeah. I mean, you're cracking jokes between takes and stuff, so I don't think you ever get, like, profusely, like, cryy, exactly, yeah. You know, or anything like that.
But I did get emotional when I saw some episodes, mm-hmm. like Simon and Marcy.
Watching them back, seeing the finished product and everything is definitely much more an emotional reaction. And as far as acting goes, there's scenes where you're acting emotional, and, you know, you're trying to get to a kind of an emotional state for those scenes and those lines. But, I mean, once you're done with that, that's... Yeah, that's the extent of it. So, yeah.
All right, thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Hi, this is for Jeremy.
Yeah.
Yeah. First of all, I want to tell you that when I was watching Voltron for the longest time, I was just like, ooh, where do I know Lance's voice from? I know this voice. And then, like, around episode 5, I was like, oh my god, it's Finn.
Ah, yeah.
And I was, for the rest of the show, I was like, Lance, Finn, but different.
Did you like Voltron?
I did.
Thank you very much. That's a Voltron Legendary Defender, shameless plug. First season is now on Netflix, so if you haven't got a chance, go check it out. It's a lot of fun. It's pretty cool. I play like a, pretty much, has anyone ever seen The Last Airbender? Okay, good. This reference will make sense, though. My character, Lance, is like Space Sokka. I'm like Space Sokka, so that's the role I fill in the show, pretty much.
When you just asked that question, that lady right there screamed like someone just told her she won $400 million in the lottery. Do you want $400 million? Yeah! Side note, sorry, we have to speed through. We're speeding. We have 8 minutes.
The actual question is if,
you combined a long statement.
Question. Come on, let her ask the question.
Look at those guys back there. They're never going to get it.
The question is, if Lance and Finn actually met up, how do you think that would work out? Because I think that would be a tragedy.
I don't think they would meet up because it's two different shows. That's my answer. I don't know. People ask me, like, so in the characterization, what do you think would happen when this person, this piece, met up? I think that they would think they're, like, on drugs or something because they're like, you look like this is a different animation style. What the frick is happening? And, yeah, so...
I'd be like, what if you met a human that was supposed to be like a normal human but just looked jacked up, you know? Yeah. It would be like...
You'd be like, you're deformed, bro. What happened to your face? That's probably what would happen.
Right. Thank you.
Yeah.
This is Jeremy. Do you ship Clance?
What?
Clarence?
No, Clance.
Clance being...
Heath and Lance.
Oh my gosh. Okay, now I get what you're saying. This is the first time someone's actually asked me a ship question from Voltron, so I wasn't prepared for that. Oh. Sorry. why would they hate each other in the show? Why would that make any sense? I mean...
Do you ship them?
Do you ship them?
Yeah.
It's like... Yes. Yes. I also, that's pretty funny. I think that one's really funny. I think Chance is really funny. Shiro Lance, I've seen like all the ship names are funny. There's Chance, there's Clance. Sheath is a great ship name. Sheath. I'm firmly on board of Lance and Laura, but that'll never happen in a million years because she's way out of his league. But hey, there you go. I don't even know what you'd call that.
Disturbing.
Yeah. So there's my non-answer.
Hi. Olivia, I met your dad back at the Miami-Dade Book Fair. You
Sweet.
Were supposed to be there and you missed it. So I got to hear...
Well.
So
awkward!
I was actually not supposed
to be there. You weren't supposed
to be
there. Your dad said you were supposed to be
there.
Your
dad was throwing you under the bus here. He's like, I don't know why she didn't come. I've been calling her.
I mean, he asked me, and I was like, I'm going to Australia that week. Like, I can't do it. And now he's like telling everybody, oh, she couldn't make it.
You
like,
chose
no,
Australia over the book fair?
You want to go to Australia? Yeah.
Whatever. Anyway, so I got to hear a little bit about your childhood because he talked about, all of his boys actor friends who would come to the house, and it must have been so terribly entertaining. I'm so envious of you.
So do you have character voices that you've created on your own that you like to do around the house or whatever? I mean, I know a lot of us like just put on a character when we're at home or sing stupid songs. Do you have your own character voice that you've made up on your own that you like to do? And I'm that's for all of you, actually.
I'm going to... Cash, do I? What? I don't know. I have a really annoying Valley Girl voice that he says sounds like most of my friends. So I do it to my boyfriend to annoy him.
Valley Girl voices are the best. Can you do it?
And I'm just like... Bamba, I love you so. He's like pinching his ears. Please, just give me. Like, that's basically what I do, just to be annoying.
Wow, that's really annoying.
That would make a good princess.
I do the voice of my dog, one of my dogs.
Oh, do it.
When somebody comes like, hey, Rosie, how are you? Are you really asking me? Are you really interested in how I'm doing? Does anyone care about me in this house? She's like a dog, like 1 foot tall. She's mini.
Yeah, I like baby talk my animals. Oh, Ziggy, Ziggy, yeah. Ziggy. Oh, it's a little kitty, so fluffy. Yeah, so fluffy, so cute.
That's the voice for the character, the kittenist. She's an expert.
Jeremy, do you have a voice?
Of
your very own.
No, I'm not that weird.
No, I don't talk to myself
all day.
So, are we talking about voices when we like talk to animals and little children?
No, just something you made up on your own.
No.
Jeremy's way too cool.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
This question is really weird. Do any of you ship the Ice King with Elsa?
Wow.
I know I didn't before, but I do now.
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I like that. That's fantastic.
No one here will never not ship them.
Okay, speed round, because we got to wrap.
Speed round.
Yeah. Really quick, just for Olivia, since you have a beautiful voice, I just really want to hear fries. Daddy stole my
Daddy, fries. Why did you eat my fries? I bought them, and they were mine. But you ate them, you ate my fries, and I cried. But it's, Daddy, do you even love me? Okay, next one.
Woo! Oh, yeah.
This is for Jeremy. I've seen all the Adventure Time episodes, like once or twice, but when Finn tells Flame Princess a joke and she doesn't understand it, and he goes into the pillow world, and he gets another girlfriend, he gets married, has kids, like, was that a dream or was that actually happened? Did he go into a different world?
Finn's been married like 9 times.
He gets around. I don't... Stop it. I think that's left up to the viewer's imagination. I actually don't know myself, but I think it possibly happened. This is Adventure Time, and we've seen weirder things, to be honest, so I think it's very possible.
Hey guys, love your work. I was wondering what it was like to work with Penn.
Good, yeah.
Great.
Yeah, fantastic.
Why don't you say the name to me? Oh, man.
I loved working on the episode Princess Day where it was just kind of me and him as LSP the whole time. And, like, if you know Penn, he is more, like, on the reserved, quiet side. And then apparently he has this other personality that lives inside him that's Lumpy Space Princess. And it's really great to see.
I mean, and also, like, the whole show. It's like the inside of him.
Yeah.
You'd meet him like, quiet guy, hello, how are you? Then inside, like, he thought up frickin' Adventure Time. I mean, like, everything he sees just, like, squirrely spaghetti arms and, like, you know.
He's cool, though. It's a good experience, yeah, for sure.
All right. This is the last question.
It better be good. I'm telling you.
It's not really a question. It's a request for Miss Marlene. I was wondering...
Marlene?
Mm-hmm. Marceline, I'm sorry.
Marlene's in room 4. Marley Matlin's here in room 4. Children
Marlene
of Lesser
King?
God.
I'm sorry. I was wondering if you can sing Everything Stays as a last request.
Yeah,
sing
I guess a good note
you
to
can
go
sing
on.
It.
Yeah. Sorry. Yeah, but I sing it in the show. Let's go in the garden. You'll find something waiting right there where you left it, lying upside down. When you finally find it, you'll see that it's faded. The underside is lighter. when you turn it around. Everything stays right where you left it. Everything stays, but it still changes ever so slightly.
I don't actually have a candle.
Daily and nightly, in little ways when everything stays. Woo! Thank you. All right, guys, give it up.
Thank you guys. So much. Florida Supercon, give yourselves a round of applause.
We'd like to thank Dana Snyder, Olivia Olson, and Jeremy Shada for coming out and answering questions.
Thank you guys.